To create a chatbot in Articulate Storyline, first, go to cluelabs.com and create a free account or log in. Under AI Tools, select the Chatbot tile. Click Create a new chatbot. Under Supported Interactions, you can select how the users will be able to communicate with the chatbot. In this case, we will select Articulate Storyline and leave the rest of the options unchecked. Next, select the desired chatbot configuration in the Information Source field. Here, you can select one of the three options. Allow the chatbot to write an answer based on the text you provide. Have the chatbot select the best matching answer from the selection you provide. Use ChatGPT to come up with an answer. We will start with exploring the first option. Paste the knowledge base in the text entry box on the page. The chatbot will use this text to write a response to a user's query. At the bottom of the page, you can also define a response for instances when the chatbot cannot find an answer in the provided text. Scroll up and select the Storyline tab. Here, you can select to enable the voice interface to allow users to ask questions using voice, and also to allow the chatbot to respond with voice. Next, click the Use the Chatbot tab. You can test the chatbot by typing a test question and pressing Enter. You will see the response under the Text Entry field. Click the link to download the starter story file that already contains all the storyline triggers you need for the chatbot. Select and copy the widget ID. You will need it to enable the chatbot. In the storyline file you downloaded, select the Variables option to open the list of variables. Locate the widget ID variable and click inside the default value field. Paste the widget ID you copied earlier. Click OK. Set up the slide and arrange slide objects as needed. In this example, to allow the character to change poses, we created 5 states for the character object with different poses. Then we added a trigger to get a random number between 1 and 5 when the response variable changes, and more triggers to display the character state based on this random number. The chatbot is now ready. We can publish the module and give it a try. Click View Project when publishing completes. Type a question in the text field and click anywhere outside the text box. The chatbot will provide a response it found in the text you saved on the website. We can return to the widget setup page and select a different information source. This time we will go with the second option, providing examples of questions and answers. Here, you will type or paste question and answer pairs. When asked a question, the chatbot will find the best matching pair and respond with the exact text you provide here. When done, click Save. We can now return to the published module and test the chatbot. Note that you don't need to republish the module after making changes to the chatbot configuration on the website. Now, the chatbot provides the exact response you saved. Finally, we can return to the website and try the last option, using ChatGPT. ChatGPT can often provide responses that are too long or don't match the overall style of the course, so it's good to provide instructions for it in this field. Here, we asked ChatGPT to provide one-sentence responses. Click Save to save the updated chatbot configuration. We can return to the published course to see how ChatGPT works. As expected, the chatbot now uses ChatGPT to come up with an answer.